This is example 8. Draw the front view, top view, and right side view of the given figure. So here is our arrow first. This is the viewing direction. This is going to be our front view, and this is going to be our right side view, and this will be our top view. So these questions may seem to be somewhat trickier, but once you start drawing, once you complete the front view, it all become very easy. And I need to tell you one thing, that as this is the last problem of orthographic projections, any questions which ask you to draw the front view, top view, or the orthographic views of an object is going to be very easy. However it may look at first instant, it is going to be easy. It may look tough, but once you start drawing the front view and complete the front view, or at least half of the front view, it will all make sense to you. So in exams, please don't panic after seeing the orthographic projections question. So when coming to this question back, we'll see first how to imagine this and what will come in the front view, top view, and side view. So observe here, I'll just paint in red the front view. So this portion here is going to be front view, and the leftover portions are two holes which are obviously hollow, that is why I have not painted them. So you have to draw these portions in the front view only. On the right, some disc-like structure, and on the left, some disc-like structure. The front view is going to be very easy. And when we come to the top view, I'll paint this in green color. As you can see, some rectangular portions only. So the top view is going to be very, very easy. Even there are disc-like shapes, it will look as if there are rectangles from the top view. And make sure that these disc-like shapes will appear in the right-hand side view also. That is why I am marking one arrow here in green color, so that afterwards you will have idea that this will come in top view also. So while coming to our right side view, I'll paint this portion in blue color. So there is one more portion, big rectangle, which is in the middle of this figure. When viewing from the right hand side, I have painted that in blue also. That is not visible from isometric view, but it will be there. And I am marking that arrow in blue color just to show you that this has also appeared in the top view also, some portion of this disc-like shape. So now we will see how to draw this in our drawing sheet. Just pause the video and observe which portions are appearing in the front view, top view, and side view.
So again, we will start with the front view first, and observe that I will start this diagram from the center, because on the left and right hand side there are curved disc like shapes. So I will start from the center, and the height of this figure is 40 mm. This is 40, and on the right hand portion is a fork like structure, and the length of this is 55, as mentioned above. I will first complete full rectangle here of this length 55 mm. Actually, I should get one curve here, but I have taken rectangle first. Now I will complete the curve portion. The radius of the curve is given as 20 mm. So what I have to do is, I have to take a distance of 20 mm from this line here. This is the axis line on which the center point will lie. And as this is 40 also, so the center point will come on the 20. This means this point is 20 mm away from this above and below line, and 20 mm from this line, and hence now you see that this portion is completed. Now there are two holes, but only one hole will be visible from the front view. And the diameter of this hole is 20 mm, which is mentioned 3 holes diameter 20. So I have to draw only one hole here. So if the diameter is 20 mm, I have to take radius as 10 mm only. So I am taking 10 mm radius and I am drawing one more circle here. So you see that this portion is completed. Now I will move on to this portion, which is somewhat behind this portion in the isometric view, but in the 2D form, in the orthographic view, they will come together. So the total length of this left hand portion of this figure is 65 mm, as we can see above. So I will take this 65 mm length here. You see that I am drawing light line here, because first I will complete the rectangle here. But actually you have some curved like portion here again. So again we have to take a distance of 20 mm because the radius is 20 mm and also this is 20. So this is the center point, 20 mm and 20 mm distance. And the hole here of 10 mm, same this diameter, 20, diameter is 20, so the radius is 10 mm. So in a way, we can say that our front view is completed. But actually, you see that as there is a hollow portion on the right hand side here, when you see from the top, as you can see in the isometric view, there is a hollow portion. So for this reason, you will get some dotted lines here. But we will draw that after drawing the top view. Now I will take the projection lines. First, let us take the reference line here, the XY line. And now I am projecting all the lines from the front view to generate the top view. And so for drawing the top view also, I will start with this center line. So the total width of this is, from the top view we can say that it's actually not mentioned, but you have to see the dimensions which are written, 15 mm 15 mm, and in the center 35 mm. So you can easily observe the total width as 65. I will draw the complete line here, but there has been some rectangular portion here, we will do afterwards. But here you need to see that I have taken this line, and now I will complete the rectangles which are visible from above. So I have to take this, and the width of this is 15 mm. See that I should not make this together. Because there is some gap of 15 mm. So from here 15 mm gap. And also 15 mm. See here, from this line to this point is 15 mm. Now I will join this figure. So the right hand portion of the top view is completed. You see the channel like portion here, and these rectangles have been formed because there are disc like shapes here. And now from the center, we have 15 mm width, and there is one more rectangle. So for drawing that, first we need to get the center point of this line, or else what we can do is we can measure the distance from this point and this point. So in total, this total width, as we have seen already, is 65, because this is 15, this is 35, and this is 15. Total is 65, and we have to draw a rectangle in between of 15 mm length. So the leftover will be 50. What I will do is I will leave 25 from this side and 25 from this side. You will see that this will automatically become 15. Simply I have to complete the rectangle here. You see that our top view is almost completed, but because of these holes here, we will get dotted lines here. So I am taking projection line from these holes, and now I will draw dotted lines there. As you know from the previous three problems that whenever there is a hollow portion, in other views you will get the dashed lines or hidden lines. These are also called hidden lines. So these hidden lines are due to the fact that there are holes which are not visible from the top view, but they are in between the object. So that is why we have taken the dotted lines here. So see, our top view is completed. And as this is a hollow portion here, we have to take dotted lines here, hidden lines. So you see that the hidden lines which should appear in the front view, I have taken this from these projections. Now we have completed the top view and front view of this figure. Now I will move on to draw the right hand side view of this figure, which will appear on the left hand side because we are following the first angle projection method. So I will take a meter line from here. So you see that I have taken 45 degree line from this the corner of this front view. Here you can see I set the drafter at 45 degree. So I have projected all the lines from the top view and from the front view also. So in the right hand side view, as we have discussed earlier, there will be three rectangles, one on this side and another on this side, So I'll complete the view. So these are the three rectangles, 1, 2, 3, which are visible from the so this is the left hand right hand side view, which are only 1, 2, 3 rectangles here. And there will be hidden lines also in here that we have to take from this circle. And from here also, indicating that there are holes which are not visible from this view, but they are present inside. And also inside this, but we need to be careful. Yes, we have to take inside also. These holes are due to the fact that we have hole on this side also. We have hole on this side also. That is why we are getting this at the center. And also, you have to do the hidden lines here. This is getting little bit complicated, but if you observe it carefully from the right hand side of this figure, you see that first there is some hollow portion, but afterwards here you have some width. So when viewing from this side, you have to take these lines as hidden lines. That is why we have drawn this as hidden lines. So this is the right hand side view is also completed now. Now we will do the dimensioning part for so I will take this is